Now, the history of tapping strings, well, to quote Jimmy Webster, the technique of hammering on and tapping strings against the frets is as old as strings and frets. Even longer if you were to look at where tapping has existed in some form or another throughout history. As an example, Niccolo Paganini utilized similar techniques on the violin. He would do this by striking the string with a bouncing bow, articulated by the left hand pizzicato. Now, techniques will become utilized by the masses if it becomes popular, and especially through a well-known artist. That's usually how it becomes popular. As an example, this guy. Now, Eddie Van Halen certainly did not invent the technique of tapping, but he brought it to the masses. In other words, those that would have never known such a thing was possible if they had not heard Eddie's playing. Let's take a look and listen to some of the oldest audio and video recordings, at least the ones I could get access to get an idea of how long this technique has been exposed to popular culture. Introducing Roy Schmeck in the 1932 film Clubhouse Party. Jimmy Webster recorded in the 1950s using a two-handed tapping method, which he described in his book, Touch Method for Electric and Amplified Spanish Guitar. This was published in 1952. Here's some clips. Now, electronic pickup designer Harry DeArmond developed a two-handed method as a way of demonstrating the sensitivity of his pickups. One of DeArmond's students was Jimmy Webster. Here's a clip of a video that is getting a lot of attention these days. It's by a radiologist by the name of, well, this goes back to 1965, so he's probably no longer here, but the name he went by was Vivitorio Camaradazzi. It was from a 1965 Italian TV show. I apologize to all the Italians out there for butchering that name.
Dottor Vittorio Camaradazzi.
Buonasera. Grazie molto per praticamente
che cos'è questa. Sì, ecco, la tecnica consiste in questo, che io invece di pizzicare la corda, la percuoto.
Sentiamo una... sì, un pezzo. Thank you.
As you can see, in 1965, that's 33 years later than that of Roy Schmeck in the 1932 film Clubhouse Party. Let's look at a couple inventors now. The first one being Dave Bunker. Let's take a look and listen to him.
Jimmy, I wonder if you folks looking in ever saw a guitar like this. Well, I know you didn't. This gentleman is Dave Bunker, and he built this guitar. Down here is the... It's really not a guitar. What do you call it, Dave?
Duo-Lectar.
Duo-Lectar.
Yes.
And you built this?
Yes, you built and manufactured.
You built, and how many strings up here on this?
There's six on the upper neck also, both tuned standard.
And how do you play this up here?
This is played with the right hand touch only. In other words, as you touch it, you produce the tone.
And how many years did it take you to build this thing?
Eight years.
8 years?
8 years.
Friend, would you play a song for us?
Okay, up next is Emmett Chapman.
This next gentleman who's coming on does something that's really fascinating, and I hope you get it quickly so we can talk about it a lot. Would our next challenger enter and sign in, please? Emmett Chapman. Panel, Emmett Chapman invented something.
Has what?
Emmett Chapman has invented something called the Chapman stick. And you
stick?
Have to figure out what the Chapman stick is. First, we'll show the audience. And let's begin with Beverly Sills.
The first thing about the stick is the technique of playing it. And you can just take one finger, play one string at one fret and get a note. So that might seem very mechanical, but you can do vibrato. You can do all kinds of finger effects. So then you can play with your other hand on the bass strings, and you can play a note, and it sustains a long time, and it's also percussive. So you can drum your fingers on it. So it's this long sustain of strings, and it's percussive. So that gives you a wide palette to paint your music from. So it's orchestral, it's bass, chords, melody, and chords. Because you have to think like a keyboardist and beyond, because you need expression. You're not just throwing hammers like on a piano. You're interacting with the string. Okay, so the technique is everything.
mention, but Dave Bunker and Emmett is who stand out in history for me, at least. Dave was the first to create and promote an instrument designed for touch playing, and Emmett brought his design to a place of greater awareness within popular culture. It's taken many, many years of hard work for it to be truly noticed and accepted, but there has been success, especially over the last 10 years. Hopefully this has given you a bit of more insight into this technique and how long it's been around. Remember, the whole purpose of technique is to play music, so whatever the technique you're using or whatever the utility, or rather instrument, making music is the goal. Peace, everybody.